Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. Today we're going to go over a Kendrick Lamar To Pimp a Butterfly style. Okay, so the style is very funky, as you might know, and it focuses around a lot of live instruments. So the first sound, the first sound selection tip I'm going to give you is to have live, organic, real sounds from Kontakt, Nexus, all the live instrument people, Sample Tank, Philharmonic, whatever you have that has live instruments, Hypersonic, Haleon, East West, whatever it may be, focus on live instruments because that's where most of the sound comes from. Now I'm going to show you some synth techniques you can use to create that funk kind of wow, wow sound in a synthesizer. And you apply the same technique to a real sound. You just have to give it an envelope and modulation like you would in guitar rig, for example. The thing with a lot of these recordings is they have guitar pedals, so they're not just playing a live bass and that's it. They're playing a live bass through a lot of guitar processing. So you can emulate some of that guitar processing in Guitar Rig 5 or Guitar Rig in general. And for synthesizers, I'm going to show you what it's, how to get that type of wow sound, that funky sound. Okay, so what you're going to do here, I'm just going to show you with a pulse wave. We're going to lower the octave two octaves. Give it a quick decay time. Okay, now I'm going to give it a low pass filter cutoff. Give it some resonance. And I'm going to go to envelope one. I'm going to set this to cutoff AB, or cutoff A, since we're on the A page. Cutoff A. I'm going to tell it to start high. So this is the max value to the right, so it's going to be an open filter. And I'm going to tell it to go up slowly over time and go down over time. So it's going to go from this position to the max position at this attack rate, and it's going to go down from the max position back to this position in the decay rate. So you create this wow. This is also a common envelope for brass sounds. Let's turn the sustain on just for. So you can hear the attack. It goes and then it goes back down. So that's how you get that funk kind of movement going. Okay, and you can use the decay time to shorten the length of the notes. Okay, so you could try that. That's a cool synth sound you can use. Now, how do we apply that to a real sound? Let's go to Kontakt. We're going to open up the Scarby J bass, which is a jazz bass sampled inside of Kontakt. Do I even have it live? Maybe not. Oh, yeah, I do. Here we go. Now, what you want to do is focus on the real articulations. So a lot of libraries offer different articulations of the bass that they sampled. For instance, vibrato. What else did they have? Let me see. I don't think this lists all the articulations. Maybe the help does. Strings, Yeah, it gives you the articulations here. So if you want a buzz trill, if you want a trill, if you want the pickup, if you want mutes, So it's the way you play. You have to look at these numbers here. Like F sharp zero means in the MIDI keyboard, we're going to play down here. In the zeros, we're going to play F sharp zero. And hold that note in order to activate that particular articulation. Now, in this case, I think the mod wheel controls the vibrato. So I'm gonna show you how to, it says controller CC number one, that's the mod wheel. I'm gonna show you how to manipulate the vibrato as well. So the first thing we're gonna start with is the bass line because that's the funkiest part. Let's get a decent tempo. I'm gonna tap the tempo. So we're around the high 90s, okay? Now for funk drums, the drums are pretty simple actually. We're gonna go to BusyWorksBeats.com. Let's go to the Virus Drum Kit, which is free. Go to Automatic. Gonna pull up the cymbals just in case we need them. Okay, close that out. So the drums are pretty simple. It goes boom, ch, boom, ch. So something hits every beat. Now this kick is on loop mode, so I'm going to turn that off and turn the auto mode off. Go to resample, right click, go to none to reset it back to its normal sound. So funk drum patterns are pretty simple unless they have a snare roll at the end, like da-da-da-da-da, you know, it's kind of ways to end a bar, but it's pretty simple and straightforward. It's just 1, 2, 3, 4. So I'm going to clone that and add that hi-hat at the end, and I'm going to add the kick there as well. So we have two different versions of the drums, pattern one and pattern two. I'm going to add that to the playlist. Okay, so we get a pretty decent movement going. Now I'm going to add a ride cymbal somewhere in here. Just on the downbeat, just on every, what is that, four bars, I'm going to add a ride cymbal. So let's double click, send this stuff to the mixer. Let's right click, insert one, go to channel routing, route selected channel, starting from this track. And I'm going to lower the ride down. Also, you want to make sure you're tuning your instruments, like your ride cymbal, etc. So let's start with the bass line. So just before you get into the articulations of the bass, just come up with a decent bass line. What do you want it to do? Maybe hum it out, sing it, whistle it, whatever you got to do to come up with a decent bass line. So there's going to be a lot of pitch bending as well as, you know, vibrato effects. So you want to really take control over your pitch and your vibrato. Those are the two articulations focused around pitch mainly. So let's just get the note value right. So I want it to go... Start on E. Now I'm going to try and mimic what I have in my head for what's the song? King Kunta, but I know I'm not going to emulate it perfectly. So we're doing octave jumps here. E to E, octave jumps, very common in bass. Now I know for sure this probably isn't the King Kunta rhythm. So you have to kind of recall some of those old funk tracks you know, and some of the riffs they use, like dee-dee-dee-dee-dee. I know you know that kind of sound. Now you generally want to copy the bass movement along with your kick, or else it's going to sound too loose and too random, because one of those bass notes wasn't supported by a kick and it sounded off. So I'm going to go here to pattern one and make sure I add a kick where that bass note is. So notice it's a double kick back to back. So when you have kicks back to back, it goes dunna. Like if I repeat this loop here, you want to turn the swing meter up just a little bit so it has a little da-dun, not da-dun, like da-dun. So just a little swing. You don't want to have too much. Now let's go to the kick. Let's go to the piano roll overview. Let's click inside the kick window, left click and drag that bar at the bottom, and we're going to lower the velocity of that kick at the end so it goes da-dum. So it goes from low to high volume. Okay, so we have a rhythmic, smooth kind of swing going on. So now we're going to add the articulation. I want the pitch to go down on the bass. Now we can't use the piano roll pitch bending stuff like FL Studio comes with, because Kontakt isn't, you know, image line made. So using, if you double click and create a slide note, it's not going to slide the notes. Okay, so that's not going to work. So what we have to do is go to Kontakt 5, select our pitch range. Let's go to 12 and let's right click, create automation clip for the pitch. So I'm going to tell certain notes to go down over time. Let's right click, copy the initial value, change your snap to grid to something where you can manipulate notes individually, which is like 1/4 beat. That'll give you enough space, and I'm going to right click. So the pitch is going down for that first note, and I'm going to right click and paste the value back in for the second note. That's too much of a pitch bend, so I'm going to. And I'm also going to change. I also want to change the starting note. I think it goes down in pitch too fast. Zoom in here. So, you know, you got to work your way through it. This is when you don't record live bass. So that sounds kind of realistic. You know, I would take your time to really make that sound more realistic. So that's the only pitch bend we're going to make with the mod wheel. I mean, with the automation clip. So let's just slice the rest out and just repeat this. So it's copy and paste. So now I'm going to show you how to use the mod, the mod wheel for Kontakt 5. We're going to go here to the top left of the window and go to browse parameters. And it's going to pull up a list of parameters we can automate. Let's go down to the grayed out area and let's select MIDI CC number 1. Remember our controller here for the vibrato is CC number 1. So we're right click CC number 1, create automation clip. So it's kind of like an on off button. Whenever the automation is off, there's no vibrato. Whenever it's on, there will be vibrato. So now we have to pick the notes where we want vibrato to activate. So I'm going to go back to Snap to Grid, 1/4 beat. So I want the vibrato to activate on the notes that hold for longer. So right here, and I'm going to just right click and create a little box of on and off. So when it's at 100%, it's on. When it's at 0%, it's off. Use your slice tool to get rid of the excess. Okay, and then right click to delete. So we can just copy and paste this. So that small variation, that small articulation change makes it more realistic. Now you can also use vibrato instead of pitch bend in the beginning. I think that would sound cooler and more realistic in this case, because it just doesn't want to, you know, sound right. So let's go back to 1/4 beat. Let's try vibrato for the first note instead of pitch bending. So, and I'm also going to show you how to delete automation clips you created, because it may override the pitch. It may not, so you just never know. So I'm going to show you anyway. So let's create a little box around that note. Be sure not to pull the rest of the automation closer, like I just did. That sounds more realistic and better. So now I'm going to show you how to get rid of the pitch automation for good. So first thing you want to do is open up your channel rack, click here, go to automation, right click on channel pitch, the initial pitch envelope, and delete it. Now we're not done though. Go to your browser. You can close everything up. Go to current project, or you can click on this tab for current project. We're going to go to patterns, initialize controls, and we're going to right click and delete the event for the channel pitch. That's going to make sure the song doesn't start off on a random pitch or on some random modulation value. Now what I'm going to do here is try and experiment with the kick. So instead of our simple kick, snare, I'm going to try and copy the rhythm. Now go back to channel rack, select here, go to all. I'm going to go to pattern 1. I'm going to try and get the same pattern as the bass with the kick. Okay, so let's go to pattern 2 now, which is the second portion. Sounds more supportive when you have the kick and the bass landing on the same spot without less confusion. So let's get into instruments you would add on top of that. So what I would like to do here is just copy and paste into the synth, so I have a synth layered on top of the bass. Now before I get into the synth, I'm actually going to mute it for now. I want to show you in Guitar Rig. Okay, so now with the Guitar Rig open, we can now add some of these effects, you know, like funk effects and different things. So let's go through the bass amps. Now before we go to bass amps, I'm actually going to try styles, go to funk, and they have an auto wah function over here somewhere, funky auto wah. try these out first because it has a built-in filter movement which creates that wah sound. So let's turn this down. So that immediately makes it super cool and realistic, like a funk guitar. We can also do, let's try funky auto wah. So here's more of a Kendrick Lamar style. That other style was a little more exaggerated funk, but this is more subtle. I'm gonna get rid of the echo though, the reverb. So now that we have that envelope, like I said, it's all based on envelopes and moving the filters and different things. Okay, so this is automated via, this is an automated filter, which basically is an envelope based on the voltage coming in. So it's a gated way of approach to the filter. But anyway, that's beyond the scope of the video. What I'm going to do is copy and paste the bass line into the Silenth and try and layer a synth over top the bass so we can create a really unique sound. So I have to be careful with the bass clashing, so I'm gonna be aware of that. Now I'm gonna create an auto vibrato effect, which is called aftertouch. So right now I'm gonna select envelope 2, select here, go to select, I keep saying select. Select LFO 1 gain, turn this up. We're going to tell the gain to go up over time. I'm going to set LFO 1 to free mode, turn the rate up pretty high to about 5 hertz or so. Select here, go to pitch, AB, turn this up to about 0.1 so that the pitch will wobble a little bit. Turn the gain up. Actually, don't turn the gain up. So if I play the key, over time it goes, it turns the LFO gain up. And then you can hear the vibrato. So let's start adding different layers, like a sawtooth at a higher octave. So that's how we can layer synths with live bass and blend them together. Now another effect is that okay, that type of sound. Again, it's all based on filters and wah controllers and different things. Again, you would need probably a live recording for that to emulate that sound, or a guitar loop, and you would run it through those funky presets here under styles, funk, and soul, and you would run it through one of the automated wah effects. So that's, you know, the wah effect. Okay, anyway, so let's move on. So now it's just a matter of what instruments do you want to back the song. You know, strings are always good for funk, just to support the song, so you could add strings. I'm just going to open up Nexus because I don't feel like waiting for Kontakt to load up too many string patches. You can go to strings. Where's strings? Where are we at? Classic and Hollywood. Well, let's do 70s vinyl strings. Let's keep it retro. Take Control L, send it to the mixer. Now, a lot of old songs just held down keys for a long amount of time. And what I mean by that is pattern 6 is going to have the keys. It's going to hold the key down in a higher pitch and just hold it. Whatever the key of the song is. Okay, so in this case, I'm just going to choose E. So you want to drag it out for as long as you can. Let's try 8 bars. A drag it out long enough. Okay, here we go. And you can have little notes come in here and there. So you would, you know, copy and paste, do that for a certain section. And that copy and paste is weird. I'm gonna hit shift and drag. Now in a lot of funk music, there's a lot of guitar work. There's not much, you know, piano work in funk music. What they use, if they do piano work, is electric pianos. So let's open up an electric piano to do some chords. Let's try. I'm trying to think of a fast plugin. I might have to go with Kontakt on this one. Pull up Vintage Keys. We're going to go to the Scarby A200 or the Mark One. That's another commonly used one. So Scarby Mark One. It's actually, you know what? The clavinet is very funky sounding. Let's do the clavinet. And where are we at? Full. Has a 70s. So right now it's loading up the samples, sounding a little weird, but you can turn the mute function on so it sounds like a guitar almost. First you want to make sure it's in tune with the song, so you want to really check the tuning. Not sure why it's so quiet. Kontakt can do this sometimes. Let's turn the volume up. Now there must be some noise level in here somewhere. Instrument noise. Let's turn that down. Okay, so I'm gonna add effects on top of that. So, you know, it's gonna sound more like a guitar when I'm done. So we're gonna use that for the rhythm. So, you know, funk is known for their rhythm guitar. Again, it takes more of a live type of thing. They even have a library in Kontakt called Funk Guitarist that has a lot of rhythms in there that you can use. Right now I'm just going to focus on key of E on the clavinet. Zoom in. Add this to the playlist. I'm going to focus on velocity because that makes a big difference. So I want to go dun 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 dun. So dun 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 dun. And I'm just going to copy and paste that by hitting shift, left click, and drag. Now for this particular sound, I want it to be delayed behind the beat just a little bit to make it sound more realistic. So I'm going to click on it, go to the wrench tool, turn on time shift or time offset in the bottom left for FL Studio 11 prior to give it more of a delayed response. So it's more realistic. I have to continue the pattern here so it can last for the bar. And I'm just gonna hit Control B to duplicate the bar. Now for certain portions, like right here and here, we can change this, make this unique, and then change this to select pattern source. I have to do it over here actually, pattern source 8. And on pattern 8, I'm going to change the notes from E to something else. Let's try F sharp. And at the end, I'm going to change the note to 1, 2. To G, okay. I don't know if that's a realistic playing style, but it sounds good. So let's add guitar rig to make it sound more like a guitar. And let me save the project real quick. And let's go to styles, funk. I want to saturate it a little bit and make it more edgy. So let's go to funk lead. And it sounds like a guitar, and it's not even a guitar. I like this sound because it's not too saturated. to have this come in during a certain time. Now I want this to have reverb so it's wider and has more of a bigger space. We need a hi-hat to kind of bring that rhythm back in. So let's go to busyworksbeats.com. Let's go to Virus Drum Kit. Let's go to something over here. Let's try, where are we at? Let's do We Made It. So let's choose this, since it's not a typical hi-hat. It's a percussion element. Open a new channel, hit Control L. Close up your browser. Let's go to, let's just add this in. So I like to right click, fill each two steps. And what I like to do is delay the sample. So it, again, it increases the groove. Let's go to the wrench tool, increase the time shift. So it's not directly on the beat. This makes it more human sounding. Now I want to give it a volume. So right click, send it to piano roll, give it a more realistic volume. I want it to go up, down. Go to the functions and lower it down an octave. Actually, that increased the octave. Let's go back. I think it blends the sound more into the background. The strings, I wanted to go up higher. It's a B, so let's move this note up to B. I'm hitting shift up. Okay, so I mean, you know, from here it's just adding chords and string support to kind of fill in the gaps. You would go to Nexus or whatever you'd like to use. Again, I'm just using this to load up some quick strings. Let's go to not choir. I don't want an ensemble. Let's go with, where are the good string patches? I forget. Let's go with soft orchestra. Let's give it some chords. So let's hit Control L, send it to the mixer. Let's figure out the chord which is going to support the movement of the track. Start with E because we already know E is in the key of the song. Add this to the playlist. Increase the octave, hit Control up. Just a little too low pitch for me. So we can try E minor, which is E, G, B. If it doesn't sound right, we're gonna try E major. So it sounds right. So we're gonna do a Tupac thing. I'm gonna show you how to get that type of sound using the pretty much the same chord. So I wanted to go, so all I'm going to do is lift this white note up to the next white note, which is C, or the next note in the scale. I'm going to lift this note up to the next note in the scale, which is A. I'm going to leave the bottom note, though, the root note, the same. So it sounds like we're getting a lot of movement, and all we did was move two notes to the next note in the scale. So I'm going to continue that movement. And I'm going to change the chords up. I'm actually going to keep that A the same. I'm not going to move the A. And I want to drop that to a sharp. Even though it's out of the scale, I think that's going to add tension to the sound. So that's how you kind of create chord progressions without doing too much work. You just want to move some notes to the next note in the scale or the note prior in the scale. So now it just comes down to a good mix, you know, getting your levels right, making things more pronounced. I'm not going to go through the mixing process. It just takes a lot of time. You can get the Mixing Academy. Shows you step by step every process in the mixing, stage, which is a lot, and there's a lot in that course. So I'll play the track twice through just as a reference, and I think I mentioned let's add an EP, an electric piano, just because I changed that to a clavinet. So let me add that since we have the chords laid out. Let's go to Scarby A200. I'm going to show you how to make it more funky, I guess. Now you can play chords different ways, okay? So I'm going to copy the string chords, paste them into the EP chords, hit Control L, send it to the mixer, pan this a little to the right, and I'm going to have these chords strummed. So I'm going to select all the notes, hit Control A, go to Tools, Strum. It's going to strum out the notes at this time. So here's what it sounds like. So we're just going to add that in the background during the verse, and it's going to run through the chorus. You can add reverb to kind of make it longer of a sound. Turn the decay time up. You can even add delay before the reverb, so it has a ping pong effect. You can pan it out, have a long feedback tail. Set the time to 4. Okay, so that's what it takes to, you know, get the Kendrick Lamar to Pimp a Butterfly funky style. So again, the mix would make the sound more modern and clear. The mix would make it sound completely different. So those are all the small techniques here and there that you can learn and use and apply to get that funky sound. So thanks for watching today. It's BusyWorksBeats.com.